his bed. Clicky buttons on a light switch, and it doesn't sound perfect, but it doesn't sound bad. It might be a little bit harsh, so I'll be doing it from a distance. If I do it too close, it's kind of harsh. But I thought it would be a waste not to have it, you know, because now you have the option. ASMR videos, but I try, and my job is making videos and live streaming. And since it's in its early stages, I have a lot of contracts to go through. Stuff is going on. I'm also doing game development for the same people. But it's very limited funding. Wasn't an otter, but like fascinating what your child brain can make up. There was also this forest, tiny forest. Sinking sand at the bottom, so you know you couldn't go there, you had to cross. And what's so interesting about this forest is that it felt so magical. It had the remnants of many things from the past. Also an abandoned skate park. Like, it was abandoned. No one ever used it. It was old and aging. In the middle. It's strange. It was on the outskirts of the forest. But yet, like, it was almost just in the backyard of some people. But it was never used. It's kind of like it was hidden in plain sight. Like, it was this blind spot in the middle of all the busyness in the towns, or the town rather. And you could go there and be completely alone. Not even to think about people coming near you. There would never, ever be people who went there, other than us kids. Throughout the ages, I say throughout the ages, probably like over the course of 20 years. That's what's so magical about it. There was this old tree that had fallen over across the river, and it was obviously really old, you know, probably hundreds of years old. And then you have this collection of historical small waterfall as well inside this little hidden. There were this, okay, it's very hard to explain, but there was this teeny tiny trickling waterfall underneath loads of bushes and tree branches. And you'd look in, you'd kind of push away the bushes and branches and look in, and you could see this just peaceful trickle coming from this little ledge, maybe a couple feet tall. So not big at all, but just this little trickle. And it was the whole thing, the whole experience was just so meditative, and thinking back to those times makes you feel kind of sad because of how things are now. You feel like they can never be as magical as they were. But more and more I am starting to think that that's not the case. I feel like I can be a child again. Last 3.5 years, I've been told that I couldn't do what I wanted to do, that it wasn't the smart thing to do, you know. And they would say, "Oh, you should just get a job on the side and then do that hobby as a part-time thing here and there, you know. Get an education, get a job, but maybe you can just do that on the side." But that just wasn't good enough for me. I didn't want to have to get a backup. I didn't want to have to rely on something else. Because if I had to do that, then I felt like a failure. And so I just never did. And for 3.5 years, I would go through hundreds of job interviews. Oh no, not even job interviews, just job applications. In countries that are not supposed to have a difficult time getting jobs. Everyone around me were getting jobs. But I wasn't. And I was trying. Assumed I wasn't trying because of my attitude, but my attitude ought not to change my chances of getting a job because I did it professionally, but I just didn't get them. And so I just gave up and I said, no more, I'm just going to focus on game development and sound, just being a part of a project that I want to do. Because if you can't do you want to do them, there is no point in living. Finding what true happiness is difficult, but I feel some of the childhood wonder that a lot of us experience as children is something we ought to never lose. Because there's a reason why we think back to those times as the most happiest times of our lives. How things can seem so crap. But they're not crap. Takes hard work. And just going for what you want to do. Wow, this is weird. But whatever. is. I'm a busy guy, so I can't make ASMR videos all the time, but I want to. And I suppose, while we're on the subject of childhood wonder and wanting to do what makes you happy, I mean, people hear this time and time again. It's really hard to really get it in, to really take it in, to realize that it's how things are. You ought to not let chances go. You need to reach out to whatever opportunity you can see. Because if you don't, and if you give up on the chances of experience, then you might as well not be alive. And regardless of the situation, the only person who stands in your way is you. If you're still listening, whatever it is that you want to do, that you feel will truly make you happy, that's what you want to do. And that could be anything, to be honest. Is crazy to some people. Me wanting to create games, me wanting to create adventures and experiences for people that would mean something to them. That seems crazy to my family, that seems crazy to the people that I have around me, but you know, they all think it's cool. Of course it is. Of course it's gonna happen. Because I say it is gonna happen. And after 3.5 years, things are starting to look up. And yeah. I just hope people who are watching this are either in the same boat or packing their lunch to get into the same boat, because it's where the party's at. Anyway, people are gonna be home soon, so I ought to wrap this up. If you like it, please like. If you don't, dislike. It helps me see what people think. If you have any feedback or suggestions, requests, be sure to put them in the comments. That helps me a lot as well. Please consider visiting my channel if you like this, and also consider subscribing. I can hear people knocking at the door. So, okay. Yep, I have to go. I hope you liked it. See ya, guys.